Hello, Danny Gamble here. I've been getting some feedback that I should do some of my comedy stuff that I do on What's It Send to People. Because they say everything I got online that is actually out there is pretty much a rant about politics or fixing the world or whatever. So I just went and watched a few of them. Yeah, I guess that's not 100% reflection. This is where I actually like to be most of the time. So. Kind of a happy place, and yeah, I tend to like things like, well, yuck yucks and stuff like that, going on comedy shows. And anyways, so actually regarding comedy shows, yeah, I don't adhere to the probably the smarter way of doing things, which is to, you know, get your set together and then rehearse and go out and tell those jokes that you've practiced and front of the mirror, and then in front of your family, and then in front of your friends, and you know, and I get it, and, you know, you're certain to get some laughs because you've ironed out the weak ones and enhanced the good ones or the somewhat good ones, and yeah, and then also when you make it sound like it's real and new and fresh in your head and just being delivered, spontaneous, but you've actually done a lot of your homework on it, but yeah, I guess I'm more of a improv comedian, and which is very scary, to be honest. It's already scary to get up in front of a whole bunch of people, but to actually go up there not certain of which tact you're gonna take, which kind of jokes you're gonna come up with, or I guess in my case mostly it's called storytelling, because I'm lucky. I'm lucky or unlucky. I'm lucky that I had an unlucky life at times. So my highs and my lows, when they're retold in a story form, and basically not enhanced, but obviously said in, with the irony and maybe in the voice now that wasn't there at the time that I had to live through it, there is a lot of humor and fun in it, and I'm sure matches a lot of people's own stories and their own life, and which is, you know, real life is always funnier than canned laughter. So yeah, so I guess I'd start to maybe if I get going here and I roll, maybe I'll just enjoy it. I still like to do like one take, maybe two or three of the tops, because, and it's usually because I just stop dead. I can't find the pause button to continue. Let's see. Actually, a couple nights ago, if I can remember what I woke up from dreaming, it was totally bizarre. It was, but I just kept thinking of funny things, and I couldn't get back to sleep, and I had to get up at 4, and here I am at 2 o'clock putting together in my head, because I didn't get up to use a microphone or write it down, some really good jokes, some good life situations. Let's see, I tend to, not raunchy and not kind of like gross type things, but just, you know, the humor of men and women, and how, you know, maybe both groups see each other at times, and always from my male point of view, but I, you know, probably hopefully have a fairly good understanding of both sides, and maybe that comes from many exes and, you know, children and daughters and granddaughters, and you tend to, you see some stuff from other people's eyes sometimes, and it's not a bad way to see the life. Oh, going back to my life stories. All right, I'm gonna pause, and then we actually, I'm gonna have a sip of my, I'm calling, one of my nicknames I call myself is Two Beer Dan, because I think before two beer I'm too nervous, and after two beer I'm too sorry. And then only I think I'm funny. An alcoholic, I hope, but maybe. All right, here's a pause, and I'm gonna see what this one sounds like just for the fun of an opening.